Yo, what's up? Behind me here, I have MC Hammer, my Tesla Model 3. And today I want to show you guys floor mats. Yeah, it's getting close to winter, and at least in the Nordic countries, everyone and the mother knows that you need proper floor mats. And what is the point of the floor mats? It is to keep the water in here and don't get it spill all over the place because of winter, because of snow. So I've been using, let me show you here. I've been using this one. 3D Max Spider floor mat for about a year now, and then suddenly I got this summer. Can you guys see? Same but different. Yes, same but different. Everyone knows this one. This one is 3D Max Spider. It's expensive but also good shit. And actually, before I love this one, except for the 3D logo here that you get on this side. Wait, this one is the passenger side. And you see 3D logo also on the passenger side. Some people actually use black color or whatever just to paint it black so it's not that visible, because you can't simply just take it out. Well, you see, you can, I guess you could try to pop it out, but then it leaves you an ugly hole there. But what, okay, so what's up with this one that I have been using? You see, it's a little bit dirty, but I've been using this one for the last few months. So it's from Taptes, and I got them from Be Good in Norway. And I think the main difference is the back. Okay, this is the 3D Max Spider. The back side has this patented I'm not sure how to explain it. It's almost a little bit uncomfortable to touch. It's like tiny little plastic spikes to grip so it won't slide. So you see, most floor mats, they have some kind of attachment, something like you have to put something through a hole and then screw it in, and then it will stay in place. But the 3D Max Spider actually stays in place because of this patented surface here. But I found out that this one from Taptes also stays in place. It has just some kind of rubber, you see, tiny rubber dots, and it also stays in place, no problem. But when you examine these two to get it closer, you see that the surface is almost the same. Huh? What's up with these Chinese people copying everything? But they apparently haven't bothered suing Taptes. I mean, 3D Max Spider, they haven't bothered suing Taptes for it. The texture is almost the same, and also the quality feel is also almost the same. I mean, when I feel it here, okay, maybe the 3D Max Spider feels a little bit better, but I can feel it with my fingers. Do you think my feet will feel any difference? No. And also maybe you can see that the pattern is slightly different. What about the edge here? Yeah, the edge, I get the impression that the edge finish here, the edge here has been slightly different. Maybe a little bit better on the original. And another thing that I noticed was that this one seems to have the correct shape already. This one seemed a bit flat when I took it out from the box. And I thought, okay, maybe it will suddenly retain the shape once we put it in. Well, it did actually do some of it, because when I took it out initially, it was more flat than this, but again, not a big problem. So this is my experience after using the no name or the copy. Let's put it in, let's see what it looks like inside. First, I can show you the 3D Max Spider. It's easy to distinguish it because it has this logo. So all you have to do to install it is just to put it in there. Well, hang on. I have to slap it in place. Okay, and then there's always this tag you want to hide. Otherwise, it looks like silly, like when you have a visible tag behind your shirt or something. And that's it. It stays in place. And then every time you want to take it out to clean it or empty out some rocks, you just take it out. And then we take the copy. Oh yeah, I can feel. It doesn't have that shape, that nice shape like the original. But on the other hand, once you fit it in here, then it also stays in place. And my initial concern with that lack of perfect fit shape was that it would look, I mean, it would kind of parts of the floor mat would poke out unnaturally. But I haven't experienced that at all. I mean, once it's there, let me just try to sit in here and then restore my driving position. Then, you see, looks and feel just the same. So I'm actually quite happy with this, to be honest. And of course, the main selling point here is that it is cheaper than the 3D Max Spyder. And also, it doesn't slide. You see, I try to now purposely try to slide the thing, and it won't slide. And in the rear, looks like this. This is also the top test, not the 3D Max Spyder. Looks exactly the same, except for, of course, slightly different pattern. So, and then I guess for the trunk, I can also show the trunk. Same thing there. Actually, this one, you see, it looks a bit, it doesn't look as flat. Again, this was also in that box, and you see, okay, so it doesn't go flush with the floor like it's supposed to. And I even had some cargo here. I had my sleeping equipment in here. You know, I was thinking, okay, let's put some stuff here to add a little bit of pressure, and then maybe it will go back to what the original shape it should have, but it didn't. So that is a small disadvantage. So if you are obsessed with panel gaps, you will probably not be able to live with this. But I guess for most other people, they can, because this one will of course protect the surface, I mean the car's floor. When you have stuff there, I remember actually in the old one, I had a little bit of damage because I put my electric scooter in here and it was scratching on this one. But at least, you know, you only damaged this one, you didn't damage the car. All right, so here you go. The Taptus, or the Chinese copy versus the original review. And would I recommend the cheaper copy? Yes, absolutely, because it does the same function. You know, it doesn't slide, it doesn't have any disadvantages, except, okay, minor disadvantage with a shape, but it's cheaper. And for me, it doesn't have that logo that I didn't like with the original. So that's why I actually recommend the Chinese copy. Oh, yes, because I'm half Chinese, half Norwegian, half German, and half Thai. Yeah. So anyway, I think that's going to be it for now. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, thank you for watching, and talk to you later.